everyone. This is Ruben.
I'm Adam.
My name's Kayla. And as you know.
And I think you might remember us from a while ago. But anyway, in case you don't, we're hoping that things go well for you.
Good.
And that you're and that you're having a good time doing whatever it is that you're doing.
Good.
Also good. And yeah, we made you guys a little video and we hope you get something out of it. So enjoy. Here we go.
Bad.
Kid, my dad was an insurance salesman, which basically meant that he went around telling people how afraid they should be to die. Now, this wasn't really significant to me as a child, because I mean I was like six and playing in the dirt, but it was significant in that he was good at his job, so he got hired at lots of different places, and he got transferred, and he got promoted. So we moved a lot when I was a little kid. So, in a lot of ways, I learned how to be the new kid pretty good. Come into a new school, look at what's going on, see what the cool kids do, and try to copy that as best I could. Sometimes I was a nerd. Sometimes I was the quiet kid. Sometimes I was the crazy kid that you never knew what he was going to say. I eventually stuck with that one. But I got good at it. But each time I moved, I had a choice. I could decide who I was gonna be, what I was gonna chase after, what I was gonna do. So, in a similar way, in the book of Joshua, Joshua addresses the people of Israel who've been moving around a lot. They've been serving in Egypt for about 400 years as slaves to the Egyptians, and been brought out through miraculous signs and wonders, wandered through the desert, had an entire generation die because of unfaithfulness, and then all these new kids finally got to enter the land with Joshua. So Joshua leads them into the promised land. Helps them to capture it, helps them to step into their promise. And at the end of his life, when he's an old man at this point, he talks to all these new kids. And he says, you know, some of you might think it's evil to serve God. So you have a choice. You can either choose to serve the gods of the Egyptians from the land that you just came out of, choose to serve the gods of the Amorites, the people that are around you. You can just basically become like them. Or you can choose to serve the Lord. And it's really, really funny what he says to them, because he doesn't say, well, you must choose to serve the Lord. He says, choose who you will. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Now, this must not have been easy for Joshua, because he grew up with people dying because they lost the promise. And it was an easy choice for him, I'm sure. But he saw the tyranny of the gods of the Egyptians, what the Egyptians did with that. He saw the debauchery and the corruption of the Amorites. He knew that their gods were just as equally evil. So he chose to serve the Lord. So, as people going into the ministry, as people going into leading God's people, which most missionaries do, have a choice. Now, someone might say, well, I'm already in ministry. I'm already doing ministry right now. Why would I have to choose to serve the Lord? And that's interesting because the people that Joshua said this to, when he said, choose for yourself who you will serve, he was speaking to God's chosen generation. Not just chosen in the sense that they were the people of Israel, but he chose them over and against the first generation who had been wicked. And he said, you guys are the promised ones. They were already serving God. And he still told them to choose who they will serve. And at the same time, this kind of exhortation might sound kind of empty because, well, I mean, choose who you're going to serve. It sounds like something you could put on a plaque on your wall. But the sad part of this story is the fact that when you read through the book of Judges, you realize just how little they took Joshua's words to heart. These people that were serving God, holding up his kingdom, expanding it, did not choose to serve the Lord. They followed what was right in their own heart. But that doesn't have to be us. That doesn't have to be who we are. Because I feel like Joshua's exhortation to choose this day who we will serve is just as valid and just as appropriate today. I guess my encouragement to you today is that even though Israel didn't choose to serve the Lord then, and even though they walked a different path, they still had the choice. And I think that we have the choice today. So I guess the question is then, who will you serve?